always holding his mother's hand in the seaside station. The streets are silent in the rain, naked and dead in their small town pain. When the train pulls in, a man alights, lugging a suitcase, battered but bright. Labels from the Argentines. Pulls down his hat, flexes his knees. Swaggers at the platform, booger on ice. Winks at the boy, kisses his wife. For a moment, they're lost in their ardor. The boy is suddenly jealous of his father. The young couple walk hand in hand up the town. The boy just keeps his head down. Past the furniture store, owned by a comrade from the Spanish Civil War. Looks in the window to his surprise. An apparition in maple catches his eye. A lawless guitar from the siege of Madrid. He presses his nose up to the windowsill. His father says, "Come esta, señor? The boy is entranced by your guitar. Here's a couple of quid down, you get the rest next Saturday. Life's like that, isn't it?" Back in the house, his parents disappear. The bedroom they go, but all the boy can hear are the strings echoing off of the maple. The father shouts out, "Hey son, soon you'll be able to play me a tango, knock spots off the sound." Then he grabs his wife, twirls her around. The boy watches in wonder as the couple cavort. Outside, the rain and the thunder drown out the chill of the devotional bell, while inside their small kitchen, the father and mother are sublimely going to hell. The boy is religious, says mass at the friary. Oh, he's got a crush on Saint Anthony. Got a hot day with him when he gets to heaven. Still out to get up at 20 to 7 in a Gale Force morning. Slates hitting the streets, exploding in smithereens all around him. He runs in fear past the deserted garden, where a man who himself is sold ever after, sentenced to roam in search of salvation. But that morning his father leaves him the station. 6 months on the banana run down to West Africa. It's up to him now. He's got to look after his tangled, bogarted, broken-hearted mother. Later for you, Dad. It was nice while it lasted. Life's like that, isn't it? Guitar, reads voraciously about sex and revolution in the county library. And in bed he tunes in Radio Sofia, gets it on with a sister comrade from Bulgaria. The librarian is worried, she visits his mother only once, is James Connolly and Patrice Lumumba. The friars don't know what to do with this communist. If he don't look out, he'll end up poor as St. Francis. Them are books is driving the poor chap crazy. It's time he got a job, he's far too lazy. Go out into the real world, meet a nice girl. Ah, he meets the girl, but she's not so nice. She wears micro dresses and stormy black eyes. He no longer has time for the county library. Learning about life in the back of a mini. Her dress is so soft, but it's nothing compared to her silky white thighs. Oh, how we'd like to go much further. So they run off to Dublin. He's drinking too much, getting in trouble. With Miles' little red book, he's ready for action. But Black Eyes wants a house, not satisfaction. In Terran Ur, but he's heard Bernadette Devlin. So it's take to the streets, rock and roll revolution. Black Eyes has gone on a boat to London. Connolly youth is exploding. So he hops a plane to New York. He's down on the deuce, hustling work and recreation when she rings him in a Richmond accent. My only darling, it would never work out. Here is the reason I'd fallen head over heels for an English policeman. So he plays the tango, remembers his father, resolves to live life like Bogart. Turn pain to music, sorrow to laughter. Live for today, to hell with tomorrow. It started at the station, waiting for his father. One moment affects everything thereafter, but life's like